Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Darren Hawkins here at Optuma, and in this video, over the next few minutes, I'll be going over some of the chart properties that we have available so you can set up your own custom colors, time frames, and defaults. So we already know how to open a chart through the new single code chart and then select the type. Or what you can do from the welcome screen, you can just double click. And that brings up the security selection window straight away. And this is where we can type the ticker symbol or name if you don't know which one you want. So I just type SPX for the S&P 500 index listed under world indices, and I'll double click to open. Now I've got mine set to automatically open with a candlestick, a single color chart. So you may remember from a previous video about the actions and properties panel on the left-hand side. So a good thing to remember is anything you want to change, you can either left click or right click. So if I want to change the properties of that candlestick chart, I just left click on any one of those candles and you'll see the actions and properties panel on the left-hand side has changed and now refers to the item that I've clicked on. Let's just go down to the properties panel here. So this is where we've got chart style set to candlestick, but I can change this to any chart style just by clicking on that. So let's change it to a bar chart. Date range is what's loaded into the system. So you can see in the history slider on the far left, we go back to 1950 for the S&P 500. So if we change that and we only want to look at the last 10 years, for example, I'll select that from the date range property, and you can see now it goes back to 2007. And we can also set a specific range or even a default start time. I'm going to set mine back to everything. Other basic properties here, default price unit, that's for certain tools that we have, so I won't go into that at this point. Filters, this is where you can show calendar days. So particularly for those of you that look at cycles and time counts, we can select that property, and now that's put in dashes for each weekend and holiday. I'll just zoom in. I'll just roll my mouse wheel there to zoom in further, and you can see that these dashes are now weekends and holidays. So that must be, this was New Year. That's why there's 3 days there. But that's another property that we can have. I'll just turn off the calendar days. Blank bars. Now that is the area to the right of the most recent bar in this case. So if I scroll all the way to the end, you'll see that there's a space between the last bar and the price margin. Now this has been set to 10, the width of 10 bars. Now this is a daily chart. So if I want to go further into the future, let's say 100 days, I'll change that to 100. And you can see that the history slide had changed at the top there. And I can now actually just scroll back to get more history. And you can also see that the gap there is now bigger. And I'm now going all the way out to September. So number of blank bars is how you can move further into the future. Or alternatively, if you want the last candle or bar right up against the price scale, set it to something smaller. So now I've set that gap to only 5. Time on screen, I've got to custom. That means how many bars are displayed on the screen. Again, as I roll my mouse wheel to show, I'm rolling it backwards to show more history, you can see the bars on screen value changes as I scroll in and out. But we can set that to a specific value. So let's say you want to look at 2 years on the screen. So now I've set that to a hard 2 years. So we're going back at time of recording back to May 2015 on the screen. And as we then roll our mouse wheel, it doesn't increase the amount of history on the screen. It's now locked to 2 years. So whenever I roll my mouse wheel, I'm always getting a rolling 2 year history displayed on my screen. I'm going to set that back to custom. Lock price ratio, that's for geometric users. Watermark, we click that, that puts the either the ticker symbol, or when that box is enabled, we can change it from the code or symbol to the closing price or the name. The page name is the name of the tab. So this one is SPX, so it's the same as the code. But if I change this to SMP500, that's what will appear as the watermark. Show caption, that basically tells us if we had any tools on here, it will tell us what's on the chart. Logarithmic scale, as opposed to arithmetic scale, so that displays the, it's good for when you're looking back in history, because it's a percentage change rather than arithmetic. So you can see in the S&P 500 going back to the 50s, these are the percentage change, but as you can see the difference there between the two price scales. Show info bar, that will put a little bar underneath the price, the date scale there, right at the bottom of the screen. So that, as you mouse over each bar, it'll give you information. Very similar to the tooltips icon, which is the wrench on the left-hand side in the actions bar. When we mouse over any bar or candle, we get the same information in the info bar as in the tooltips. I'll just turn that off again. History slider is the blue region at the top of the screen, so we can hide that if we want, if you don't want to show that on your chart, particularly useful if you're publishing. And chart key, that puts a little icon on your chart that can be moved around, and that will display what's on the chart in terms of price and also any tools. Okay, I'm going to zoom all the way back in to the most recent price action. And when the bars are compressed, they will go to single color. That's why it looks slightly different when I zoom out and compress the bars. I'm going to get rid of that watermark as well. So go into the properties and untick show watermark. So now I'm going to click on any bar in this chart, and you'll see the properties now have returned to the properties of the actual chart, where I changed the chart style from candlestick to bar. This is where you can also change currencies and color scheme. So for example, S&P 500, it's in the US. Actually, it's an index, so it's not technically a currency, but we can show it in different currencies. So we can look at it in relative to the British pound or any other currency that you would like. I'm just going to put it back to default USD. Color scheme, set to strength at the moment with two colors, but we have a number of various color schemes. You can just have a single color. Time intervals, based on any, this one set on weeks, so different weeks are differentiated by those two colors, and we can change that to months or any of those other options. Swing relations is also a popular one, so I'll just zoom in there to show you what that looks like. So swing relations basically is, there's four colors, higher bars, so a higher high and a higher low. Lower bars are red. Outside bars, so today's high is higher than yesterday's high and low is lower than yesterday's low. And inside bars. And a couple of others, if you're professional services or you have the relative rotation graph module, you can also set the bar colors to the RRG quadrants. So we'll explain more about relative rotation graphs, or we have videos on our website about them as well. And also, we have custom bar colors. Now, that's going into more of the scripting language that we have, so you can learn more about that at our scripting videos at learn.optuma.com. And that basically will allow you to create your own formulas and display bar colors with your own custom settings. Okay, line width. So again, we can change the width of these bars. I'm just either rolling the mouse or typing the value or even moving the slider. So there's various ways you can do that. And transparency, that is also quite useful because you can roll that slider down and you can see if you've got tools or indicators that pretty much anything that we put on the screen, we can change the transparency for, to highlight them or to make them less obvious. We can use that as a setting as well, or we can hide totally, and we'll show some examples of why that might be useful later on as well. Finally, show in price scale. That will show if we tick that, and I'm just going to go to the current bar. That puts the last value of the closing price in the price scale. Now, let's say that this color scheme with this line width and transparency and everything like that, I want to set that as my default settings. So every time I open a chart, it has those values. We go over to the actions panel at the top left of the screen, you'll see save settings as default. And as we click that, there's a little message in the bottom left-hand corner saying successfully saved settings. So now when we open up a new chart, it will have those remembered settings. So that was a quick rundown of the chart properties that we have available. If you have any questions, as always, let us know at support@optuma.com, or you can go to our online knowledge base at help.optuma.com. Thanks very much.